Alright, hello again YouTube. This video is going to be about these remotes, how to fix these remotes if they suddenly stop working, and I'll show you what's going on in these. Generally, I mean, what I happen to think it was the battery, but it ends up not being the battery. If you test the voltage on these with a multimeter, you know, it's a 3-volt cell. So I've only had this a while, and stopped working, one button specifically. So these are the 3-volt cells that go in these, and you might be tempted to think that it's the battery. Test the battery, make sure that it's got over 3 volts, so it'll be like 3.1, 3.2, whatever. It's not the damn battery if it's not under voltage. If not, replace the battery, try that. But it is the on button, and I'm gonna rip this off. You know, it kind of looks like you might have to get into that, but you don't. This is just an adhesive with these contacts. I'm gonna try to get into this without sort of breaking shit. Let's see if I can do this on, there we go, on camera. So it's just a sticker with contact pads on the back. You can see I've already had a go at this. I've tested this, this does work. So this pad here, the these are carbon contacts. And what these do is they sort of bridge the connection between these pads here, which are sort of generic, and there's a chip on the back that sort of detects that, sends the appropriate frequency, whatchamacallit there, UV or whatever, not a UV, infrared light to the receiver, and you switch on or whatever function you're trying to use here. Now, again, what happened was it didn't want to turn on, and so if I look at this contact pad, I've put it was actually just rusted. You can see that there is some rust residue here. It's supposed to be a carbon contact, but for some reason I've got corrosion there. I don't know why there's corrosion. I don't know if it's built to do that, but if yours stops working, you can try this. What I've got here, I just happen to have this around. This is foil tape. This is for duct work. For those in the HVAC industry, I'm not in the HVAC industry, I just happen to have a job where I needed that, so I've got this left over, got a little bit left, not much left actually. This is kind of expensive, so this may not be worth it for you, but if you do have this around, you can try this, or any other contact type of adhesive will work. So I just basically cut out a small square, put that on there, and then you basically go ahead and realign this to your remote, hoping this is on camera. And you try to line it up, and you just basically get it back on like that, and then you go test it out. That button works now. So that's a quick tip for you guys if you are if you got these. This just happens to be this brand here, Uberhaus, which was some no-name brand that I've never heard of. They may be a brand, I don't know. These are just the LED strip lights, and this is the remote for it, and I've had these for a while. They have a 1-year warranty, but I wouldn't go by that. If you take it back to the store, or maybe it's over warranty, this tip may save you throwing the whole damn thing in the garbage. They are pretty good lights. I do recommend them, but the remote, of course, is built to a cost in China. I understand perfectly that things are generally built to a cost these days, and so things like this will tend to be common in these types of remotes. So if you do have this problem, there's a way how to fix it. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.